You are sick. Like some of the tangible miracles we see here. Now this guy that was brought couldn't from the hospital carry this guy. He is 31st or something.
And
then I said, you are healed. They carried the person back home. And I said, 2 weeks. It's okay. And then 2 weeks, he stood up. You are here. And it's still the same.
Said,
why? And do alikato samande. Yalu ombo and the ando ribaka. You know why? When God speaks, listen. He's not saying it to happen. He's saying it because it has already happened. No, some of you should have stood up and shout. Are you here? Are you here? Like the woman, our member's brother, the child who had been in hospital for so many weeks, taking injection upon injection. And then the situation grew worse. They brought the child here. I look at the child. I said, 21 days. The child will be completely and walk. The 20th day, the child got up. He said, man, I'm walking. The 21st day, he started running. Are you here? When I said it, I'm not saying it so that it will happen. I am saying it because it has already happened. Glory be to God. Are you here, somebody? Are you here, somebody? The Bible says that faith is the substance of the things hoped for and evidence of things not seen. So faith, it is not the means to get my prayer answered. Faith is the answer to my prayer. So what is the evidence that I have a baby? It's not because I'm like this. It's my faith. And faith. Things like the way God thinks. Faith. Talk like the way God talks. Faith. Act like the way God acts. Why? Because God is faith being. Chapter, he said, I have made you.
Or say, my yield.
Are you here today? Listen, sometimes you are going through something, you are expecting something, and you had a prophecy, or you were convinced by the Holy Ghost, or you read the word, and the word said, it's done deal. But after that, the situation rather grew worse. I remember years back, we were a group of men of God, and I carried some too. I said, I own the end of the world. I travel to every country. I'm preaching the gospel everywhere. On big platform. I'm spending dollars. I'm spending this. But that years with these, I was consistent. Say consistent. With this profession. Because my heart was one with it. And after I've said those things, the situation grew worse. Sometimes no food. And then my sisters will tell me, you who say go to the university, you say God has called you. Who will see what you will eat? Are you here? But I kept on talking the word. I kept on saying the word. Are you here? And some of the friends went away from me. Listen, what you are saying does not exist. I say yes. Yes. Say it again. It doesn't exist. I say yes. That makes me a Christian. Because a Christian that believes in something that exists is not a true Christian. Are you here? We are born from heaven. We are born of the Spirit. We believe in the Holy Ghost. We believe in the Word. Are you here, somebody? Hey. Say yes. 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 10 years. 20 years. 50 years. You have not seen anything. Oh my brother. I told you on Friday. A book I read about a woman. This woman will always have a dream. that she is in the hands of God. And because of that, every day things will be going well for her. It continued for years. And then that dream ceased. Now in her dream, wouldn't see God again. See in God's hand again. So he started worrying. We worry with our mind, not our spirit. Okay, I'm coming back. So he started worrying. He was so disturbed. As a result of that, things got worse. So one day, he sought the face of God. And in her dream, the Lord appeared to her. He said, "My daughter, if you give birth to a little child, always, you the mother will carry the little child in your hand, because he cannot walk, he cannot talk. So you'll be dictating to the child, directing the child as to how and where he should go. But when the child grows up, what do you do? You don't carry the child." He said, "When you saw me in a dream carrying my hand, you are a babe in the Lord. Now you have grown. So when you think you are not in my hand, I was behind you. Are you here? Directing you where you should go." And the lady said, "Thank you, Jesus." And he believed it, and things started getting better than before. Are you here, somebody? Are you here? And I told you, some of you pastors, sometimes you think, or some of you Christians as well, you see, your life is dry. You have prayed and fasted. Sometimes you are tired of praying and fasting. So what appears to your mind every day is this: God is not with you. He is not in you. Let me tell you something. The time those things were going on, that was the time God was very close to you. I told you, me, I don't like preaching. I don't like teaching. I don't like traveling. It's the calling of God. Sometimes I feel dry. I'm going to preach again. I'm going to travel again. What kind of all these things? God, where is you? But because of this mindset, listen. If we are born a Ghanaian, say ya wo so we Ghanaian. Let me tell you something. Whether you have problem or not, you are still a Ghanaian, and you live in Ghana. If you are born of the spirit, whether you have a problem or not, you are born of the spirit, and you live in the spirit. Come on, shout! Are you here? Are you here, somebody? 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 The devil is a liar. I said the devil is a liar. He cannot touch your money. He cannot touch your room. He cannot touch your finances. He cannot touch your burger. I said the devil is a liar. Miracles in you. God lives in you. The Holy Ghost lives in you. No one says yes. Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
And let me blow your mind. Under the Old Testament, the Spirit of the Lord did not permanently reside in the people. Because Jesus had not died and resurrected yet. It came on them and then lived. And when they sin, the Spirit of the Lord leaves them forever. They need to carry a goat for another year. But after the resurrection, the Spirit of the Lord has come to reside in you permanently. Listen to this. If you sin, listen, I didn't say when you sin, so that religious folks would misquote me. I say if what? It means that sin is not part of you. But when I say when, implies that it's something that you can do it and it is part of you. If you sin, the Spirit of the Lord does not leave you. He's still there.
The
righteousness of God is still there. That was why David was a prophet. In Psalm 51. He said, restore unto me the joy of the spirit. Not restore unto me spirit. The spirit is already there, but the joy of thing has left you because of the state of your mind. Are you here? That is why you can say, Lord, forgive me. Let the joy of the Lord leap in my heart, and the joy start leaping in your heart, and you continue your journey. Remember, I say, if not when. It means that you don't continue in sin, being born again. Say, acting the word. That's why, you see, that's the problem we have. That's why, sorry to say, you know, I don't condemn any man of God. I don't condemn for any preacher. But let me tell you something. We do not judge, but we prove judgment. Now, John chapter 14, the Bible said, Jesus said, believe in God and believe also in me. Listen, all the people who came to Jesus, they heard of him and they believe in him. If you believe in God and you don't believe in your man of God, nothing will. So you don't need to sit there. That's why I tell people, if you are here and you believe in God, you are a Holy Ghost filled demonstrator, matures, dancing body body, and you don't believe in me, don't be a member here. Because leadership is crucial.
What?
Some of you are getting why I'm saying this. Mahama, president. Now, you see, the word vote, I don't want to go to. The Latin word means voto or vum, or voto or something like that. Forget. Now, listen. From the religious background, the word vote.
Now,
that's what I'm preaching, but that's what I'm bringing. It means, what it means is this. You deliver your life into the hands of the person whom you are voting for, that from this day forward he or she should decide where your life should go. The word vote, that's what it means from the Latin word. I don't want to go there. Are you here? That's why leadership is important. So when you said no problem after everything, you the same people who voted for the man to be a president, you are complaining. Listen, if you study in high level from academic point, democracy is one of the dangerous things that the world should rise against. Because he gave the difference between the poor and the rich.
If
he
said this,
that is why the Commonwealth countries. Listen, when you say a Commonwealth country, you know what it means? It's a royalty. It means the wealth in that country is common. So as a royalty, every member, every citizen of that country is a queen or a queen. And so he has right to the wealth, because the wealth is common. That's why Jesus, he brought kingdom. Kingdom. Kingdom means the wealth is common. That's why in church, listen, nobody should be like this. Let me say, you see, these people are the more rich people. These people are poor. So the pastor of that church is very close to only the rich people. He get their attention, visit their house, and say, these are poor people. No, in the kingdom of God, the Bible said in 2 Corinthians 8 verse 9, it said Jesus became poor, that through his poverty we might become rich. So from the Bible standard, every Christian is rich. Are you here? Let me tell you something. Don't think you are poor. Don't say you are poor, because you are not.